here in Maryville, Tennessee, as the flagman's gonna give them the one to go signal. Just a beautiful sight of all 24 starters lined up in double file action. The final race here at Smoky Mountain for 2016. Donald McIntosh, Chris Mann, they're gonna jump on a loud pedal. Here we go. In the turns, one and two, Donald McIntosh gonna take the point. Down the back stretch they go. Ryan Keith's gonna get up on it. Wow, he's gonna put it on that. Lap number one. Three wide off turn number four for the sixth position, but Donald Mack lead lap one. Who's gonna hit the money? One wild man to turn him down to turn two, caution out. Ryan King got a little bit out of shape. And here we go, we get the field back into double file, restart out of turn number four. They're gonna drop the hammer here. Wow, Derek Ellis getting up on your lead early on that start mile. And the turns one and two, Derek Ellis down at the bottom. He's coming after Matt for second. Shannon Buckingham and Chad Ogle squaring off for fourth. Caution on to the speedway. For the number 18 machine. Benji Shaw. Derek Ellis trying to be ready. And here we go, lights are out. The flagman's got the green flag in his hand. In the words of MC Hammer, they're going to hammer away out of four. Here we go. Chris Mann said, I'm ready for you this time, buddy. He's going to drop it down to the bottom in one and two. He's gonna hold on a second, but he's gonna put it all over Donald Mack. He's gonna try to wind it up top, but Donald Mack's gonna lead lap number two this time by. Oh, goodness! Corey Hedgecock to the top side. Hear me? Oh, we got one into the wall. It's gonna be Porkchop, the 71K of Jim Rogers. All right, they're gonna tuck them in tight out of turn four and they get on the hammer. Here we go. Chris Mann back down to the bottom again, shut the door on the rest of them. David Payne up top and he's gonna pull up on Buckingham to the outside as they head down into turn three. David Payne's gonna make it work out of turn number four. We got a new fourth place man while Donald Mack leads. Smokey's trying to make that top side work and it's digging hard. He's trying to pull up on Tommy Kirk, on Donald Mack. He's running him down out of four. What a race already here at the mound. Smokey up on that top side and he's gonna throw the hook out trying to reel in that big fish. Oh man, out of four, good God, they're racing, coming to the line, wow. Oh, geez, dipping and dabbing, Cam Newton slide over. Man's about to show you how to dab on these suckers out of four. Man coming at him again out of here, they're getting it on, man, what a race. Donald Mack's gonna put it up top. Let's see what the young man out of OD back, see if he can wind that Blood Motorsports entry up. And he's making it work. He's going to put it up on the top rope, going to do a flying elbow in a while, and he going to wait for that. Oh, wow. But man, not letting him out. They're wheel to wheel out of four lap traffic coming into play. Donald Mack, Craig Greer, Bryce getting out of the way, the 18 machine that made Madden bobble, but only for a split second, Derek Ellis, the ditch digger, trying to get that new shovel and dig that ditch in on the leaders and pull them back in. Donald McIntosh, butts not the new dance on these boys, doing the money dance, the money walk. Here comes Matt again, the punter returns one. Side by side, wheel to wheel, smoke, he's gonna let it out and turn on the turbo and down he goes. Donald Mack said, oh no, brother, this fight ain't over. Out of 4-3, wild with the left bar. Oh my, heavens to Murgatroyd. Holy cow, Batman, we need to get up on it. Trying to make lap traffic as the pick to run down your leader. We're 12 laps into this one. What you're gonna do when Chris Mann runs wild on you? And God Almighty, Donald Mack has put that thing to the bottom and he's coming after him. Oh my God, look at lap cars. Man, oh man, Donald Mack to the bottom. Here we go, brand new leader. Get up on it. And Matt's gonna take the lead back, but Donald Mack, that young man ain't scared of him. Who's got the right flavor? And it's Donald Mack. I don't know what that boy's on, but he's on some good Cheech and Chong, and he is pushing on these boys right now. Hide the clouds. Here comes Manning. Back to the outside. Ryan King has got your leader to defend. Oh, the crowd's on their feet. What a race. And that just might have been what Chris Mann needed out of the 1G of Ryan King, because that just gave Chris Mann a 12 parlay lead and caution out onto the speedway. In turn number two, we got one sitting on the access of pit road. The distance between him and Madden, who will set the pace of the field when they drop the green. Interesting development. Donald McIntosh is going to choose the outside, but no one starts until the green flag goes. Out of turn four, let's dip and dab on him. Out of four, here we go. Oh. Derek Ellis and, David Payne off the pace in turns one and two. That's gonna bring the caution out onto the speedway. Back up the dirtondirt.com cruise with the champions rookie of the year chase against Jim Rogers. But that field coming out of turn four, looking like a fine glass of wine, and her name is Beyonce. Here we go. One and two, Derek Ellis gonna try it up top. Him and Donald Mack, D-Mac, they're getting at it, going down the back stretch. And Madden's already up to about a six car length lead as they cross the stripe. Derek Ellis trying to battle with Donald Mack up top as he's got that Vic Hill, Longhorn by Weaver, working to his advantage, but man, that seven is gonna snatch it back in front of him. Like we said earlier, Chris Mann walking away from this field already up to a 1.6 second lead over Donald Mack with Derek Ellis in third, Shannon Buckingham fourth, Todd Morrow fifth, Ben Elwood sixth, Hedgecock seventh, Tommy Kerr eighth, Stephen Roberts ninth, and Brad Skinner about to fall back to Bobby Giffen for 10th. Man, this battle for second, Donald Mack and Derek Ellis, the ditch digger, trying to get that shovel in and dig up under them as they come out of turn number two. Corey Hedgecock has brought it to the pit area, but side by side out of four, what a race coming to the line. Derek Ellis will overdrive in turns. Number one is going to allow Donald Mack to get away from as the field's going to tuck it down to the bottom and start digging all and dipping and dabbing in the ooey-gooey sticky mud. And around they continue to go as they're past halfway. 22 laps in. 18 to go in this feature. Chris Mann starting to run into lap traffic. With 17 laps remaining, Shannon Buckingham running a strong fourth. But look at this battle right here. Tommy Kerr, Billy Ogle going into turns one. Tommy Kerr gonna use that nose like a bull and he's gonna put him out of the way and he's gonna take over. That Smoky Mountain steel cage is finally starting to get some balance in order as Chris Madden has found his tempo, dancing like his Usher, and getting away from these boys. And Steve Smith in the number three is gonna bring it to the pit area as his night is now over. In your top 10 at the moment, Chris Madden, Donald Mack second, third, Derek Ellis, fourth, Shannon Buckingham, fifth, Todd Morrow, sixth, Tommy Kerr, seventh, Billy Ogle Jr., eighth, Stephen Roberts, ninth, Bobby Giffen, and 10th, Brad Skinner. The field has gotten spread out and starting to get in a little more single file racing. And Chris Mann's gonna split the lap cars out of four as he's trying to get those guys a lap down, but Derek Ellis has reeled back in Donald Mack. Twenty-eight laps into it. Tommy Bailey going to lap down the Big Show. Ryan King, the 1G machine. Next on the dead list for the 44 to snipe and put him out. Tenth and 11th, both in danger of going to lap down, but the battle for second is really starting to rub right now between those two. Donald Mack, Derek Ellis going into turns one. Derek Ellis down at the bottom as Donald Mack trying to dive around this speedway and find some grip. Todd Morrow having a fantastic run. Strong fifth place run for a man with a spec motor under the hood. Sitting fourth in the Southern All-Star Series points. He will lock in fourth with a start at the Alabama State Race next weekend. And Chris Mann's about to get into the top 10 and lap him as he's working on Skinner. Lap traffic, the most wanted list at Tear Group, has been a thorn in the side of your race leader, but Chris Mann wisely taking it up on the top rope and putting those moves to work and working on these boys with seven laps to go. He is putting some on this field. He has lapped up to seventh as Billy Ogle Jr. is going to go a lap down with five to go. Oh, boy, here we go again. McIntosh and Ellis getting at it. They have yet to let it go. Derek Ellis is now up to second. Donald Mack up top. Four laps to go this time behind. Derek Ellis deep D-Mac. Michael Rigsby dubbed O'Donnell Mac the name D-Mac. We're going to let it stick with it with the boys on Dirt on Dirt. Oh, my God, Derek Ellis. Donald Mac. That battle for second, pushing and shoving. Ric Flair elbows getting dropped everywhere. What a race here, Smokey Mountain. Amount of money waiting for him with the white flag about to come out on this field. One more time around. Can Chris Madden pull the money dance? Pull the money walk? A brand new dance on these boys. That's one bad and bougie man coming out of four bad and bougie checkers, man. Who's gonna get second? It's gonna be a drag race. Wheel to wheel. Here they go, and Derek Ellis to hold on. McIntosh third, Buckingham fourth, and Todd Morrow will round out your top five. Now, Chris, you came down to this event, man. You ain't too long got back into the racing scene after your injury that took you out on the sidelines, man. How does it feel to get that another big win here at the Mountain this evening?
It always feels good to come up here and run. You know, them guys always work hard and give us a good racetrack. You know, it was a heck of a race there with Donald. Me and him put on in lap traffic, but I knew if we could just ever get to the front and get clean air, we'd be okay.
Now, early in that race when lap traffic starting to get into play there for between you and Donald Mack and Derek Ellis, what was going through your mind, man, dealing with that treacherous group in the back half?
Nothing, just stay smooth, pick my lines, and make sure I didn't slip the tires. And I'd like to thank all the guys that worked hard. This is a new car we brought here to try to get ready for some of the bigger shows we got coming up at the end of the year. So it's the first lap on it. We're very pleased with our new ride, so looking forward to the end of the season.
Daphne, you still got a lot of big events coming up to Alabama State next weekend, as well as a few other events coming up. Are we going to see the 44 climb back in the Southern All-Star victory lane before it's all said and done for 2016?
I hope so. I think we're going to try to come back by Sunday maybe and run with you. We're going to Magnolia for 20,000 at the cotton picking next weekend. So, depending on how it goes, we'll come back and see you Sunday. Thanks for all the fans that's coming out, supporting all the drivers that have been hurt. We really appreciate it, they need your support, and we all do. So thank you all for coming out and supporting us.
Now, you got one key figure that I don't see in victory lane right now. Your good luck charm, Mr. Avery. Where he's hiding at today, buddy?
he had a ball tournament today, and he's got one tomorrow. So we had to leave early on the second game today, so we headed back home to see him play tomorrow.
Sounds like a winner. Let's hear it again for your race winner, Chris Smokey Madden. All right, we're down here with our second place man here tonight, the ditch digger, Derek Ellis. Man, you came out, you had a fantastic qualifying order, started up towards the front, they dropped the green, you stayed in the hunt all race long, man. How was it out there battling out for 40 laps?
We had an awesome race car. Shorty's been working his tail off and got us going in the right direction. And the racetrack was awesome, it was real racy.
Well, definitely we can say on that. Now, a few times you had some touchy moments on a couple of restarts between you and the number 7 machine, man. What was going on out there on some of those touchy starts?
On that one restart there, I got in the field there, and it kind of showed the front end, and we made a little contact, and they didn't like it, but,
There's always so much you can go about on that one, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, definitely, you still coming off that huge win up in Rome, Georgia, a couple of weeks ago. How much has that helped get this car set up on towards the final run of the season here, buddy?
It's been good. The past several months, we just ain't showed for it. Now it's finally paying off showing.
Definitely. And with that also coming up in mind, who all you want to thank for a fantastic second place tonight?
I want to thank my mom and dad, and my wife and kids is here, and Cecil works hard all week at the shop. Shorty works on the shocks and car. Buzz his tail, and Keith's been busting his tail, just everybody.
Well, definitely, man. We got a couple more big races coming up. What's going to be the next event we're going to see the ditch digger at?
Possibly Magnolia next week.
Now that's going to be a good one down there to Johnny's place. Let's hear it again for your second place man tonight, the Ditch Digger, Derek Ellis. All right, we're down here with our third place man tonight, D Mac, Donald McIntosh. Man, you started on this pole. You fought tooth and nail with one of the best in the country up to that lap, till the caution came out there, buddy. What was going on through that entire race there?
I had an awesome race with Chris. We raced back and forth, lead. We never touched. It was a great race. And I can't thank my team enough for giving me a great car, Stowers Cat, Blunt Excavating, Vic Hill Race Engines, everybody that's a part of this team. Everybody makes mistakes. I wasn't given any room on that restart, and I don't think I was really raced fairly there. But, you know, that's part of it. That's racing. And I guess we'll go next time.
Well, definitely, man, throughout that race, this car, it didn't start out looking wrinkled, but on a couple of starts, you, Derek Ellis, and Chris, man, y'all made a couple of contacts there, man. What was all going on in those crazy restarts here at the mountain?
I never made any contact with Chris. Me and Chris raced clean as could be, hard, good fought racing. 99, I don't know. Just didn't want to give me any racing room. Apparently, you know, he just wants to rub, which, you know, some people race that way. That's fine. I felt like I did him clean, and we ran our race, so we come up with a third tonight.
Now, taking out of everything that's went out tonight, what can you take into the closing races with the World Finals and everything looming on around the horizon?
Running as close as we did with Chris Madden and being able to shake it up with him, I'm really proud of that and our team, and to be able to be that good. We still got a few little tweaks to be where he's at, I think, but overall, I'm happy with where we're at.
Definitely. Great job on the third place run. We'll see you again soon, buddy.